हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम अगेन कमिंग बैक टू द टॉपिक्स इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रीलिम्स एग्जाम एंड द मेन एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द यूपीएससी एग्जाम. नाउ अगेन इन दिस वीडियो आई एम लिस्टिंग द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम अर्थ साइंसेस विच अ कैंडिडेट नीड टू प्रिपेयर फॉर द कमिंग एग्जामिनेशन. नाउ ऑल दिस टॉपिक्स आर फ्रॉम माई साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी बुक विच इज़ पब्लिश्ड बाई ओकब्रिज पब्लिकेशन. सो इट इज़ ऑलरेडी अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट, इज अ रिवाइज एडिशन. At the same time, you can also purchase through Amazon or Flipkart. It's available in the online segment also there. Now, this book has been revised and it covers previous year question papers, both for prelims and the main examination. And I've given concept, application, current aspect, government programs, all inclusive of every aspect is already covered. So here, in this particular video, I will just list important topics from Earth Sciences. Now again, this particular video is not about any detailed concept and application theory part from each and every topic. It's only just a list of topics which I'm providing from the textbook, so that you are prepared with the topics and try to solve questions wherever you have a practice papers there. Though I've also given the multiple choice questions for practice in the chapter of this book. So let me now here go through the important topics there. Earth sciences is very important for Indian development, and particularly from meteorology, seismology, then atmospheric sciences, cryosphere, and it has got interconnection with number of areas, not only energy, then again living and non-living resources obtained from marine areas, at the same time from national security and defense part also. So what I've done here, in this chapter, I have given about ocean resource planning in India, then about ocean development in India. Ocean development in India comes under Ministry of Earth Sciences. We have a department called DOD, Department of Ocean Development. So I have given about the major achievements of DOD in recent years. Then drugs from sea, the different medicines which we can get from marine organisms. Then geostrategic importance of Indian Ocean, that's from the security point of view, given the marine environment, macrocosm, geopolitics of oceans. You could get question in the main examination. Sea and maritime boundaries, oceanic routes and international canal, ocean transport and trade from economic point of view, maritime trade, marine environmental degradation and marine pollution from environmental perspective, then changes of sea level rise because of climate change impact, marine pollution like oil spill or any other economic activity which affect the coastal areas and high sea. Then corals in danger because of the pollution, the climate change, global warming, ocean acidification. Another very important area where UPSC had asked question in the mains examination about polar science like Antarctica and Arctic study and cryosphere. Now when we say cryosphere, it is not only poles, north pole or south poles, it also includes the mountain glaciers. And for India, Himalayan glaciers are very, very important. They're melting at a rapid pace because of the climate change impacts. So I mentioned about the cryosphere research in the textbook. Then about Arctic research, that from the South Pole Antarctica research, which India started in 1980s in terms of Antarctic expedition, where we have built three important research stations. That's the first was Dakshin Gangotri, we abandoned it. Then we built Maitri in 90s, and then now we are using Bharti. But then we also started North Pole research, where in Svalbard, that is a small island near to North Pole, which come under the sovereignty of Norway, India has a bilateral agreement with Norway, and we are doing the Arctic research there. One question I would like to add here, which already UPSC had asked question in the exam about IndArc, India Arctic Experiment, to understand ocean temperature, current, salinity, and link with the monsoon and the climate of India. Our scientists have been researching there in part of Norway. So I have also given that part. Then I am coming to very important coming exam question, Svalbard Global Seed Vault. It was in the news that it completed 10 years of its existence. It is the biggest seed bank of the world. It is also called Doomsday. Many countries including India have given the seeds of different crop varieties which have been kept under cryopreservation condition in the Svalbard Seed Vault. So that is another very important topic, and UPSC had not asked any direct question on this seed bank. So I have given there, it can be asked in pre-exam, at the same time main exam. I have also given about India's seed board. That is the second biggest seed bank of the world after Svalbard. That's in the Ladakh, Leh Ladakh. The name of the place is Changla. Changla seed vault is India's doomsday, where we have stored seeds of various crops and plants. So that is the second biggest worldwide. So I've given about that. Again, that can be a part of the question. Seismological research in terms of earthquake prediction and warning. So you can link earth sciences with geography at the same time, environment and security part, plus science and technology. So I have given early warning system for tsunami and storm surge. So in Hyderabad, we have a very dedicated research organization, National Center for Oceanic Information Services, that is called INCOIS, Indian National Center for Oceanic Information Services, where we have tsunami early warning system set up for the Indian Ocean part. So not only India, we can give a warning to other neighboring countries of the Indian Ocean if there's any impending earthquake under ocean and tsunami. We can always give this warning. So that's a warning system is very important from disaster management point of view. It is very, very important. And you know that 2004 India was impacted by tsunami waves. So that's what the government of India went ahead and established this early warning center for tsunami. So I have also given major achievement of earth sciences. Till 2017 you have the achievement part of it here, but the other achievements I have given other part of the chapters in the textbook, plus you have in some other topics given in the same chapter there. Then open sea cage culture, which in terms of marine resources, in terms of, let's say, incubation or growing of some kind of prawn or let's say shrimp or mollusk or crustacean, the research has been done. Puducherry beach restoration, that is a coastal degradation and restoration part. Monsoon mission program I have given. Scientific deep drilling in the Koyna region, there's an intraplate seismic zone in Maharashtra. So that dam and the seismic induced seismic activity, that I have given there. Then about the radar and Doppler weather radars, which are used for various study of winds and the kind of meteorological data. Then I have given about desalination of water, very, very important. And in this part, I have mentioned about ocean thermal energy conversion system, OTEC plant, set up in Lakshadweep island to provide desalination and potable drinking water to people in Kavarathi. And again, remember that it is very, very important from energy point of view, where we can generate electricity. At the same time, very, very important from the part of the water supply, drinking water supply for Lakshadweep island, particularly in the Kavarathi and all this one. So please make sure to go through OTEC technology and the desalination plant called LTTD, low temperature thermal desalination plant, that has been set up in Kavarathi by the Ministry of Earth Sciences. It's a very, very important topic, and I mentioned this topic, the scientific and technological part, in the new and renewable energy chapter, which I've already covered in another video. So make sure to read that one. Then about high powered computing for Pratyush and Mir. They are the fastest supercomputers in India as of now, and they've been developed by CDAC Center Pune. Now Pratyush is being used by IITM Pune, which is a dedicated research institute under Ministry of Earth Sciences. And Mir has been installed and is right now working with another important research center of Ministry of Earth Sciences, known as National Center for Medium Weather Forecast in Noida. Both NCA WMR and IITM are research institutes working under Ministry of Earth Sciences, and Pratyush and Mihir, which have together 6.8 petaflops, they are used for meteorological research and forecasting of monsoon and different type of research. So already they are there in the current affairs, and the questions can be asked in the exam. The detailed part, the other facts you will find in the chapter. So I've given about a summary of the chapter, plus you have exercises there, practice questions, preliminary exam and the practice question for main exam. So now this is the part of the chapter number 10 from the part of agriculture and earth sciences, part 4 of my science and technology book. So please make sure to go through those important topics and prepare for the examination there. So I hope that all these videos which I prepared and provided you the list of topics to prepare for coming examination will help you a lot, and I wish you all the best for preparation of the examination. My objective of all these videos are that at least the students know the topics and they can read and study and prepare for those topics for the coming examination. I thank Oak Bridge Publication for taking this initiative of providing such videos online and let the student know about important topics. If you have any query, any doubt, any suggestion, you can write to info@oakbridge.in. The publication house will readily look into your doubts there. So I thank each one of you for watching this video and taking more advantage of this textbook. So thanks a lot. Keep on reading, keep on preparing for the exam. Best of luck.